Notion Mail just launched for all users, and I think it's an amazing new way to approach your email inbox, currently only Gmail with more planned later. What's unique is that you can use properties and views that you might be familiar with if you're a Notion user, similar to a Notion database view. If you're used to seeing emails simply by date, you can group your emails by other properties like labels or priorities. You can also save email snippets easily, seamlessly connect to your Notion calendar for sending your availabilities, as well as being able to access the power of AI for auto-labeling and writing emails. In some ways, it's a more customizable experience than Gmail with a clean Notion aesthetic and AI capabilities. In this video, I'll be showing you a full guide on getting started, current limitations, and my personal thoughts. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first step to using Notion Mail is to create a Notion Mail account. You do need a Gmail associated with your Notion workspace. Once you have that, you can go to notion.com/product/mail and then click Get Notion Mail. Once you click that, you can click Connect to Google. And then it's going to ask you some questions where you can choose how the sidebar is going to look like for you. And this is going to come mainly from your Gmail account. So for example, you can choose to split or keep in the inbox calendar, social, or promotions. In this case, I'm going to split the social promotions and then keep the calendar in just like it suggests me here, but you can also adjust this later. So now this should be what your Notion Mail looks like. And if you want to add Notion Mail as a desktop app, you can do so for macOS. You can find the download here or over here. Unfortunately, Windows and also mobile apps are coming later, so keep an eye on that. If you want to add Notion Mail while you're in Notion itself, so if I'm over here and I want to add Notion Mail, I can actually also just click this button over here. So those are the two options for getting started with Notion Mail. So now that we have an account, I just wanted to go over everything you need to know to navigate your Notion Mail. Notion Mail operates really similarly to Notion itself with a clean sidebar that looks basically like it would in your Notion workspace. At the very top, you can see what account you're in. Here you can see that I'm at this email. You can also see your other emails here. The only thing is that you can't see your inbox combined together in one place. You do have to switch back and forth if you have different Gmail accounts. Then we have the search bar here, as well as the button to compose new emails. If you want a more minimal style, you can close the sidebar and you can have this layout as well, or you can pin the sidebar. Then we have the views underneath the search bar, and here you can customize it, have different views based on labels, properties, and more. And I'll be covering this later. And this is where a lot of the power of Notion Mail really lies, is in this views. Underneath here, we have our mail section. These are just standard sections where you can see all of your mail. You can see mail that you've sent. You can see drafts and you can see your trash. This part you cannot edit. Underneath the mail section, we have settings, and you can do all kinds of settings here. And then if you need any support or have feedback, you can click here for that. There's a chat with Notion support over here. You can also access this question mark to see the support and feedback. This is really important, the keyboard shortcuts. If you want to navigate Notion Mail really quickly, then it's really useful to learn the keyboard shortcuts. Some of the most simplest ones, for example, is that you can just click C to compose an email. So that's very useful. Then we have these two buttons. So this allows you to go to Notion, and this one allows you to go to Notion Calendar. So they can be really useful if you're switching around between these three apps. At the top, you can see that in Notion Mail, you can see auto labeling, you can see your filters. If you're in your inbox, you'll be able to also edit the views, and there's also a refresh button. The refresh button can be useful if you don't see new emails. Make sure to click this if you don't see emails that you think should be in your inbox. Next, let's go over filters, views, and more. So this is where a lot of the power of Notion Mail lies, and that's in being able to create customized filters and views and even custom properties. So to create a new view, you can click plus new view here, and then you can either describe your view, which connects to auto labeling, or configure manually, or you can even use a template. And here you can see things like by priority or by your calendar, all your events and meetings. So this is a really good base if you want to have some ideas on what kinds of views you could create. For example, I can just click minimalist and add that view, and it's going to give me a very stripped down version, as you can see, where it removed a lot of the properties from each of the emails. You really see just the title of it and the time. So if you really want something simple, this would be the most simplest version. You can also customize the view in your inbox too. So if I'm here in the filter, you can filter out all of the emails that are labeled. For example, if I only want to see my coaching emails, then I could click this one. I can also see the unread by clicking this one. So you can do a lot of filtering here. And then in the edit view, you can choose to do groupings. So you can group by things other than date. I would highly recommend grouping by priority. This is one of my favorite ways to use Notion Mail, is the fact that you can do priority. So if I click this one, then it automatically goes into this mode. What I like about priority sorting is that I can just drag it into different sections as I need. So for example, this email, interested in coaching, I would put this in important because I need to make sure to reply to this one. In Gmail, I've been using the star in order to mark emails that I need to reply, but I do like that I can actually put them into waiting or to do or important, or even add my custom priorities so that I know exactly what actions I need to take on my inbox. So the first step I would recommend with using Notion Mail is definitely to try the grouping with the priority. You can also do a lot of other things like grouping by label, grouping by unread versus read. So I do like the fact that you can see this in different groupings, not just by the date. Another really cool feature that I wanted to show with the views is that you can change the icons. So for minimalist, for example, if I click rename, you can see here that I can basically access all of the Notion icons and the Notion colors. I really like this touch so that you can really move from your Notion to your Notion calendar to your Notion mail and have the same aesthetic. You can also add basic emojis as well. So I like this customization here. The other thing I wanted to showcase is in the edit view, you can also add properties. You can see here, add property. I could add, for example, a checkbox, have that be something very customized. If I need to review the email, then that would become part of the email. So you can see here that I can check this box. The other thing I wanted to show is that you can decide to show your properties or hide your properties. If you go to the edit view here and then go to properties, just like with a Notion database, you can choose to hide things. Let's say that the body text just clutters your inbox. You can just hide that. You can hide the from even, or the subject. So it's a lot of customization here, depending on how you want to see the inbox. If we go to the minimalist view, you can see that it only shows the title of the email and the date. Next, let's go over reading emails. When you want to read your emails, you can easily just hover them to see part of the inside of them. You can also hover this way to access things like star this email, archive, trash, mark unread, and also set reminders. You can also edit these things by going to customize hover options, and you can create customized hovers. So if I go to add hover action, I could even add this reply to sender already here. So now you can see that I have one here. The other thing is, if you open up an email, you can also access the remind here, auto label similar, which means that it's going to start labeling similar emails together. Then there's going to be unread, add label, archive, trash, and also you can mark as spam, report phishing, or block. So those are the options when you're reading an email, as well as accessing the properties. The next thing I wanted to show you is for composing emails. To do that, you can type C or click the compose email button. So I'm going to go ahead and click C. There's a lot of features here that make Notion Mail really useful. So let's say that I'm going to email here and the subject is hello. So inside the email editor, you can basically use this just like you would in a Notion block editor, which means that if you type slash, you can have all kinds of options that you'll be used to if you're using Notion, including text, numbered lists, quotes, call out, to-do list, and all of these things. So I think that this is really cool that you can basically use this just like you're in a Notion page. The unique thing here is the schedule. So if I click schedule, I can now connect this to Notion calendar and show my availabilities and send that over seamlessly. Now, if I type /schedule, I can just click here and then choose availability bookings. And that's going to sync with my Notion calendar. So now I have my scheduling link. Scheduling is super easy here. You can also add your insert availability using this button here. You can also click here to access your snippets. Snippets allows you to save custom email templates to make things faster. So for example, this one, here's my Zoom link. You could just insert your Zoom link here. You can access snippets by typing slash, and then you can assign slash commands to them as well. So slash Zoom link would go to Zoom link. It's also easy to change your current email into a snippet if you click this and then turn into snippet. You can also create your own snippets this way. Assign a shortcut. So for example, discovery call, and then I could put my email that I would respond to people who are interested in my discovery calls. I can also add things like this where it would fill in the first name for me depending on the email. So I think that this is a really cool way to use Notion Mail that you can save a lot of time, especially if you're always writing similar emails. Like you can see this one, I can just enter my key points after a meeting and it just saves me a lot of time. You can add attachments just like you would in a normal email through here, and then you can also access AI through this one. Another cool feature is that if you type at, then you can get to your Notion pages that you have in your Notion workspace. I could link to getting started page that I have in my Notion workspace for this account and send that link to someone. Next, let's go over all the ways that Notion AI becomes a part of your Notion Mail experience. In order to utilize these features, you do need to have a Notion AI upgrade on the workspace that's associated with the email account that you're using. But one of the biggest features is this auto labeling. So if I click auto label, what I can do is that I can automatically label things that are relating to, let's say, Notion. So I could split Notion emails into its own view, or I can keep it in the inbox, but it's going to start labeling them Notion for me. So let's say that I want a new view for Notion, then I can click here. And then it's going to start searching for relevant emails so that I can check through what would be an email that should be tagged with Notion. So now what I can do is decide which of these emails belong to the Notion tag so that it can learn which ones to filter. So for example, this one is from Notion Mail Team and this one is from Notion Team. So I'm going to keep everything that is relating to Notion Team or Notion Mail Team in this Notion tag, and then I can save it. So now I have a new view called Notion. You can see Notion Team and Notion Mail Team already inside of here. So this saves me a lot of hassle, and it basically is going to organize and reroute future emails going into my inbox directly here. I can also access this auto labeling feature by clicking new view and then describe your view. This is a really useful way for auto labeling. The other things that you can do that can be useful is, let's say that all emails coming from the organized notebook, I want to auto label them all in similar category. And now it's suggesting me to label them download confirmation. I can actually edit this. So instead, I could say that I want this to be the organized notebook. I can also add the description like this, and then I can choose to split it out or keep it in. I'm going to keep it in my inbox this time and then save. So now you can see that it's created another view here for me, which has all of the downloads from the organized notebook. So in that way, you can really manage your different emails and different parts of your life into different views, which I really like. Some other AI features are with the writing part. So if I go to my coaching here and I want to reply to this email, and then I can press space to access AI, I can basically ask it to reply to this email, hit enter, and then it's going to come up with a draft for me, which saves a lot of time. And now you can see that it's basically given me an option for this email, and I can just accept it and then send it off. So This is a huge time saver in terms of composing emails. Next, let's go over the settings for your Notion Mail. You can click settings down here, and then if you go to inbox, you'll see the theme mode. So you can choose system, light, or dark mode. The system means that it changes between light and dark depending on your system settings. And the light and the dark mode look like this. You can also choose your thread style, whether they open in side peek, center peek, or full page. This is the same as how Notion database items open, so I think this is really cool. Then there's auto advance. You can choose where to navigate after archiving or deleting a thread. You can go to next thread, go to previous thread, or close the thread. And then you can also choose the font size. So if you want regular, small, or large, then you can adjust them here. The next thing you can see here is Notion AI, and you can see all of the auto labels that we've created and its descriptions. You can also edit them or deactivate it depending on how you want to use it. So I like that you can see all of the auto labels. You can check your Gmail filters as well. So those are filters that come directly from Gmail before it lands into your inbox. That's also useful just to check. And if you click here, you can edit this one. So the next one is snippets. You can see all of your snippets here. If you want to edit them with the shortcuts, you can edit it this way. You can even edit the icon, and you can also go here to edit the full snippet inside and change it up. Then we have signature. You can choose to include on replies and forwards. Default signature, show sent with Notion Mail in your emails. So you can toggle this on or off. And then if you really want to edit the signature that's coming from Gmail, you do need to open it up in Gmail and edit that. Then we have your account. You can export your data. And then here there's two links so that you can check your members and plans. The next thing I wanted to cover are the limitations with Notion Mail. Some of the limitations that I've been surprised by is that you can't download your emails or turn them into a Notion page, especially with the downloading emails. That can be really useful for me personally because I sometimes need them in PDF format. The other thing is that you can't see multiple email inboxes in the same place. That would be such a huge game changer if you could see different kinds of emails all in one inbox. And some other things are that if you delete a single email inside of your email thread, that's not going to get synced between Gmail and Notion Mail. So you do have to delete the entire thread in order for it to actually sync between the two. And finally, I would recommend to read the documentation in full detail if you want to know exactly what kinds of rules are in place. There are also some things that you should be aware of with the labeling and the way that it syncs between Notion Mail and Gmail. So if you're interested, I would recommend reading the help and documentation so that you know the up-to-date information about what kinds of limitations there are and also what kind of things that they're working on. So I'm pretty sure that they're going to come up with iOS very soon, as well as they've been mentioning that they plan to have access for Outlook Mail and also for Android. So I think that those are coming soon, but be sure to check the documentation. I think that Notion Mail is a great start with being able to organize your inbox in the customizable style that Notion's known for. Being able to add custom properties, groupings, it all feels like a Notion database in table view. If you have Notion AI, I think it can save you a lot of time with replying alongside the custom snippets and using the auto AI labeling features. That being said, as of now, there are some limitations with Gmail only and not seeing multiple email inboxes in one place. I feel like there's a bit of a delay between the inboxes syncing, which is something that I found in the desktop app, but I'm sure that these things will be ironed out eventually, and I do see a huge potential here. Have you tried Notion Mail, and what's been your impressions? I'd love to hear your thoughts, and I hope to see you all in the next video.